Twycross Zoo in the East Midlands is home to some rather large waste makers.
We've got 5 elephants on the section, 4 females, and then 1 little calf who's a male.
On average, these Asian elephants will eat over 250 kilograms of food per day. Over 50% of what they eat comes straight out the other end. It's zookeeper Matt O'Leary's job to keep on top of a daily mountain of dung.
First of all, we have to clean up their mess they've made throughout the night. We brush all the poo into the middle, not into one nice pile, and then we can just come in with the wheelbarrows, long-handled shovels, and just get it all in the barrows, up the ramp and into the trailer. That gets pretty much full every day. We take about 12 wheelbarrows, maybe more of poo a day. Sometimes it's close to a ton of poo.
So why is it so important to clear this stuff up so often?
In the wild, they go off, they move from place to place to place. Obviously, there's no one there picking up poo behind them. It's not necessary. But obviously here, if we just left the poo in there, obviously they'd be sleeping in their own feces and in their own urine. So it's very important that we clean them up.
That sounds like a very smelly task.
Being in with them every day, you kind of get used to it. And sometimes it's worse than others, but we kind of don't really notice it anymore. If you ever go into the shops after work, you forget how bad you smell.
It's the same for senior keeper Luke Harvey.
I don't notice it at all, but you go home and you get told you stink, but I don't think it smells.
Elephant's dung is just fibre, and none of this waste will go to waste.
So this is all ready to go down to the composter.
But the dung also provides important information about its creator.
How we tell really if an elephant's as well is pretty much by their faeces. You can tell by looking at this. It's all nice. If you look at it closely, it's all got hay and straw in there, which is pretty much all they eat, so there's nothing wrong with that at all. See, it's nice and round, it's firm. If an elephant was unwell, it'd be sloppy. I wouldn't be able to pick that up. I wouldn't want to pick it up. It would stink. So that's fine like that. That's a real nice round poo. We're pleased with that.
There are several uses for elephant dung. Some people even make paper from it. But here at the zoo, there's a more pressing need.
So I've picked up the elephant dung and I brought it down here to our compound where I will unload it into this pen here. And then it will be pushed through this machine here and eventually come out here, all nice and fermented.
The composting process is a steamy affair. The elephant dung is added to other recyclable products.
It's a mixture of everything we've got on the zoo, Bratley. It's straw, hay, bits of paper, twigs, cardboard, elephant muck, giraffe muck, the lot.
It's all very environmentally friendly.
Using this compost is a totally new way of going on. Normally, it's thrown away into the quarries or the landfill, but not now.
It's a never-ending story of filth fighting.
We do this every day without fail, because if we left that for a day, then it would just mount up, probably wouldn't even fit in the trailer.
Not that Luke objects to dung shoveling.
I don't mind doing it at all. It's good exercise, really. And there's nothing wrong with this. It's all fruit and veg, so it doesn't smell. Well, it doesn't smell to me anyway, so I'd do this all day if I had to.
This is John Thompson.
If you're going to work with animals, it's made very clear very quickly that a lot of it is cleaning. So it's something that obviously we don't mind doing. It's a privilege to work with the animals, so we don't mind picking up the poo every now and again. It's not bad at all.
With the elephants outside, it's a chance for keeper Hayley New to carry out the daily deep clean.
We wash the house at about 100 degrees, so obviously to kill any bacteria or anything. It's very important just to make sure all the faeces and urine is completely washed off the floor for the elephants' hygiene, especially for their feet. Things like little stones that get in their feet can then become infected if you leave the faeces and the urine on the floor. Now the house is all ready, so if we need to put any food down for the elephants, which we probably will do today because it's quite cold outside, so they'll need to come back in, which means that the house will get dirty straight away again. But that's what you have to do, just constantly clean up after them.
With a clean elephant house, it's a good time to check on the elephants themselves.
We check the elephant's health, We give them a quick scrub, and then we're going to hose each elephant down and possibly give one of them a big tea tree oil scrub, so their skin's nice and fresh. Also, if we need to do any foot care, this is when we do it.
A healthy elephant is a clean elephant.
Being able to scrub them, we can like get rid of any dead skin that's forming, and obviously get rid of any bacteria that might be forming in the dead skin. It is better for the elephant's health for us to be able to go in and do this and see any defects that we could also then go back to and treat if necessary. It's a great bonding process as well for the people and the elephants, so it's important for us to do it on a daily basis so we can keep up the trust and the friendship, if you like, between keeper and elephant.
Man and beast, it seems, can live in filth-free harmony.